up guys, Adam here at ECP, and I've got another show for you today. Today I am at the Harrogate Car Enthusiast Show. They hold this annually, obviously in Harrogate, and the sun's out, and as you can see, there's a great turnout. There's various cars, there's Mustang cars, supercars, modified cars, there's even a steam engine over there. There's a great variety, and I really look forward to going around these and showing you guys what's here. And it's definitely an event you should turn up with your family. I mean, there's other children there, there's people just relaxing. There's some stalls, some bouncy castles, so it's a great day out. I would highly recommend for next year for you guys to turn up. And it's definitely a good turnout. So furthermore, let's get around these cars and look at these beautiful models that we have on show. Hi guys, we've got my beautiful ST there, which is always the star of the show. Give me a thumbs up if you think so. We've got a beautiful couple of Subarus here, STIs. This is the GB270 model, so these are limited edition. Really good condition. Also got the quite old school one. Now this is in really nice condition, very clean. Obviously, Mark II ST 2.5, beautiful sea grey. Running a stage 2. Obviously got a beautiful Audi S4 V6 8-speed. Really nice. Everyone loves the Audis. Lovely MR2. What colour is this?
It's a base coat black with natural crushed pearl and lacquer.
Natural crushed pearl and lacquer?
Yeah.
That's nice.
120 quid for 2 ounces.
Wow.
6 ounces on the
cap. 6 ounces? You can definitely see it sparkling in the sunlight.
At night time it's black. You go down the road it's black. Yeah. Obviously when you go under the street lights.
Just glitters up.
Yeah.
I bet that's really nice. If you went along the Scarborough Sea from the lights, that would look nice. Got a lovely Honda Type R. What's the standard power on these?
320.
That's the best thing about the new hot hatches. They're already 300, 400 plus, aren't they?
This has it's had the TDI tuning box on it.
All right.
So it's about 345 at the moment.
345. These are all wheel drive, aren't
they? Front wheel, yeah.
Oh, is it just front wheel drive?
Front wheel, yeah.
I thought these were four wheel.
No. There is a conversion that you can buy for the back wheels, but it's
too much.
Yeah, that's silly money.
Right, what are we talking?
£3,000 a wheel, I think.
£3,000 a wheel, so yeah. £6,000 to go four wheel.
So it's got like two motors on each wheel.
Yeah, but imagine what a knock to 60 would be.
Oh yeah, it'd be nice, but...
Yeah, not a nice bill at the end of it. Oh, it's nice, I like it. Got a pair of RS3s here. Maxim design diffusers, I like them. We've got the white and the black. I like these. I don't like them. We've got the Maxim design. Maxim design splitters. There you go, mate. Beautiful car here, but I don't know what it is.
Honestly,
I can't figure out what it is. There's no badges on it. All I can tell you is it's got clean paintwork. I'm loving them Recaro seats for the matching stitching. So obviously, I think we're definitely looking at JDM. Definitely JDM. Cream of the crop here, buddy. Was it Escort RS? RS Cosworth. Now, Ford owners will be drooling at this right now. Both of them?
Yeah.
So you're definitely a Ford mad?
I'm really?
So you got a...
Escort Cosworth.
You got the Cosworth?
RS Turbo.
And an RS Turbo. What you got at home?
Focus RS Mark 2.
Focus RS Mark 2.
And then I've got a Cosworth.
Wow. Every Ford man's dream. This is really nice, great condition. These as well, 182 Clios. I had one of these, a black one. It wasn't in the best condition, but if you want something that's quick and fun, cheap to buy, you want one of these. Maybe get the trophy if you can afford it, because they're worth a bit more. But these are real. 5 seats, naturally aspirated brew. Brilliant.
HD, it's the 16 valve 2 litre HDI. Yeah. Not the 16, less than 6 seconds.
No? See,
underestimated, I think.
I was just about to say that these are underestimated cars, but I've seen these highly modified with nice body kits, and they do look really good.
I'm thinking of putting it on airbags.
This is all
stock at the moment.
Yeah.
There's going to be new exhaust put in.
Yeah.
It's going to be put on airbags.
Yeah.
I'm going to have an all new skirt all the way around.
Yeah.
It's going to cost me a bloody arm and leg. I'm keeping the Archer silver because it goes with a silver then black.
Yeah.
Keeps it original in that way, but unique to me.
Yeah.
You get all the inside hydro dip looking nice.
Yeah, I like hydro dipping. I do it myself. And it's a cheap thing to do as well.
It's nice.
And it does look nice.
If you do it right, it looks nice.
Once you get it done, I might see you on another show once you've had it all done one day.
I hope so, yeah. It's going to take me a long time because it's costing me a fortune as it is.
You don't buy cars like this for economics, do you?
No, you don't, no.
Well, it looks.
You have to do so.
Well, that's it. It looks good, buddy. It looks good.
Oh, thank you.
Nice Vauxhall Adam here. My wife loves these, not because it's the same as my name. I don't know why. I like them just. Got an absolute beautiful Ford Mustang 1968, I think it is. 2+2, is that right, Sapper?
Mm-hmm.
That is in an absolutely pristine condition. Now, this is the same car you'd find in the film Bullet. It is the film Bullet, isn't it? Obviously, not the exact car, but it's the fastback out of the iconic Bullet film. Beautiful. We've got a beautiful Chevrolet Chevelle. White wall writing on the tyres, which I love. Oh, that is a beast, everyone. There's such a diversity of cars. I mean, classic big. I was going to say big block, but I don't actually know if it's a big or small block, so I'm not going to drop myself in that. But it's a lovely big engine. And another Corvette. Now, we saw one of these at our last show, but I couldn't figure out what model it is. What model Corvette is this? Does anyone know?
C3.
C3, so it's a C3 Corvette. There we go, it's a C3. We saw one of these at another show, I couldn't figure out what it was.
Yeah,
C3. Nice. Very nice there. I would say, right, we've got supercars, modified cars, Mustang cars, with everything kit, but this is one of my favourites. This is a V8 Plymouth. A V8. I mean, the whole sort of pitted, rusted look, I love. Guys, honestly, I can't begin to tell you how big this is. I mean, the snapper goes to one end. Easy.
Right, so picture Focus ST, and it's nearly two Focus STs.
Honestly, beautiful. It's got the bench seats. I mean, I love it. I absolutely love this. I would love to cruise around in this. Moon discs, massive, guys, absolutely massive. And beside that, we've got a massive. Is it Chevy?
Yep.
We've got a massive Chevy. An Impala. Come on, an Impala. Wow. I mean, I love the brown. Look at the paintwork on that. It's amazing, guys. Brown interior. Oh, that is beautiful. I would have one of these. If I could afford the fuel, I would have one. Moon discs again. Wow. That's probably a similar size, would you say? To the similar size. American cars here, we've got Trans Am, three Mustangs, Triple Trouble, different years, but beautiful car. I mean, and at the end, out here we've got a beautiful Bel Air. Now, this is definitely one of the best looking cars here, all round.
Yeah.
From loving the white and red, or cream and red maybe, I can't tell because I'm wearing my sunglasses. I mean, just look at that interior, guys, that is amazing. I mean, this is a rarity to see a car like this up close. I mean, these kind of cars you only ever see at shows, not every show as well. I mean, look at that rear end. That is almost as good as mine. Huh? You laugh, don't you? Laugh at me. Got some nice, nice Vauxhall VXR8s, is it?
Mm-hmm.
We've got a selection of four here. Got the rare, is it Bathurst you pronounce it?
Yeah.
Now, I was briefly speaking to these guys. I think we're running, I think the first two are running approximately 500 plus horsepower. This one here is running 800 plus. And this one's back to about 500 plus. Really nice.
668.
Yeah, sorry, not 5, I do apologize. 668. Hey, run your weekend.
First to about 500 plus on there?
Yeah, yeah.
That's brand new. These first three are all had the supercharge added onto them. Yeah, these first three are supercharged, and the first one's naturally aspirated. Now these are absolutely beautiful, guys. I'm tempted to buy one of these. What we'll do is one of the guys, the owner of this one, has said that he'll start it up and give it a little tickle, so I might show that later.
Really nice.
Very nice, very nice.
Max,
set of cars going here. I mean, obviously, I'm into cars, not so much bikes, but that looks cool. I mean, you got the rebar. This is Mad Max all the way.
So Harrogate Athletic.
Definitely a custom job. I'm really into that kind of one. I mean, just take a look at this London taxi. Double wheels. That's cool. I don't know if you can tell, you've got a chain wheel. I mean, we've got a couple more Mad Max looking trucks, and in the middle we've got this absolutely pristine Ford. I don't know what Ford it is. Now this is actually for sale, if anyone's interested. Ford with a Chevy engine. Yeah. We don't know. No one knows that. Well, they do now. It's on camera. Yeah. Yeah. Got some nice mugged-looking trucks here. I mean, I like the ones that have had a proper paint job, but then I like the ones that have had like a rugged paint job like this. I like this more. I would have one of these if I could afford it. I mean, you look at this one next year, this is just an animal. I mean, even with the rusty holes. But that's been professionally treated, so it stays like that.
I mean, everyone's
choices are different. I like the rugged look, instead of the pristine, totally refurbished look. Beautiful, it's nice. Look at that. Looks like, is it Mater? It's a bit like Mater of cars.
Oh yeah.
Or the film Monster Cars, is it?
Monster
Trucks, that's it. Yeah. That's it. Very nice. Ford Meet North East Club, I think it is. And a car from my own breed, NST. And he's done some great work on the engine bay. Now, I intend to do something similar to my engine bay on this. Obviously, it's got a nice hydro dipped. From Kung Fu Panda. So you got Po. I don't remember the other names.
Master Shifu.
Oh, Master Shifu. Yeah. That's it. Is this your car, buddy?
Yes, it is. Yes.
Nice.
Airbrushed. No,
it's not hydro dip. It's airbrushed.
All done by my friend Peter Colson in Sunderland. Yeah, all airbrushed.
Wow.
Done it all by hand and.
Airbrush,
yeah, and lacquered and done it over again, yeah.
So it's really nice.
So you got the upgraded induction, RS clutch, RS clutch, what I need, got the KMS 18 inch back box with RS 5 inch tips.
Oh, you got
cost me a bit extra.
Oh, you got the 5 inch tips. Yeah. I'm running 4 inch tips on mine, but I like the 5 inch.
Yeah, I should have 5 inch.
Are they 5 inch? They look like 6.
No, they're 5 inch.
Are they really?
Yeah, the 5 inch tips. Nice. The RS version, yeah. The RS.
So, see, you got the rear diffuser on, you got the RS spoiler on.
Yeah, the RS spoiler's been painted by a different painter of mine, and it's got the orange flex in, so it's got the actual the three-stage pearl in the spoiler.
So it's nice. So it's got the rear lights as well.
Yeah.
That's nice, but it's nice. That's good. Thank you very much.
Maria, another thought. Another Fiesta. I think it's the Mondeo SP.
Could be wrong, it might be just D badge, but it's looking good.
Did you grab a little
maybe below?
Martini detailing.
I can't tell what wheels they are,
but they look nice.
Got a Revo 2 on it, so I'm guessing it has a Revo Stage 2 map on it. Looks good.
It's an RS 1600. I don't know too much about the Fiesta, so it might be. It looks good, though.
I'm really going into the classic scene. I really am. I'm going
I've got one.
I've got four TBRs here. TBR 400 SE.
Very good.
4 litre
V8. Just in the passenger door. That's
right. Up to 16.5.6 seconds, this does. Never thought about that.
Sure,
quarter mile in 14.2. Big, isn't it? That's big.
No, somebody told me that.
I'm a sucker for grey. Nice, isn't it? Very nice.
Yes.
What's the difference?
I've seen them before on the line.
Yeah.
And fiberglass makes them a lot lighter.
It does, yeah. Because I was just looking at the 0-6 and I was surprised. And that makes sense with it being the power to weight ratio,
This is a 6 second car.
Yeah,
that's which is still fast by today's standards.
That's quicker than my ST.
And I'll be a betting man, I bet it'll still do it as well.
It probably will.
It's quick, they're quite quick because they took the gearbox, it's quite tall, first and second, very tall.
Ridiculous.
I could be off the line before you've even thought
about it. So it's got a lot of torque low end then. It's nice.
The little boys in the courses and the Fiestas don't want to have a go at the lights, I'll tell you that now. They're seriously embarrassed. Wheel spins up.
To be fair, everyone likes embarrassing the Fiestas, don't they? And the courses. No, they're really nice. Enjoy your day. Good talking to you. Got nice V-dubs actually. That is a very clean engine bay. What mark is this? No, no?
Two.
Mark 2, GTI.
Yeah,
I
love it.
Really? Look at the closing tape. Well looked after. I like the BBS wheels on this. The BBS wheels go well on this. I'm not a Volkswagen man, but I think I'd have like the Mark 2s, Mark 1 GTIs Golf. I mean, these have got good power, and they've got the retro look to them now, especially when you're sticking like BBS wheels on them.
Is that the stack at the police station?
That's what we've got. Yeah, I mean, that's really good.
I'd have that one.
Yeah, I'd have that one. That's a good idea. Yeah, Turbo Rabbit. Another clean one.
Yeah.
Was it a pickup version?
I think so, yeah.
It might be modified. Gold BBS on it again.
Loving the colour.
Is that actual wood that they're stuck on?
Yeah, so it's put like some like wood pinstriping on it.
And I've just bought a new spoiler. I've just
said, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, yeah, I'm liking that. Liking that.
Yeah, I like the older Volkswagen than the newer ones. I'm not a fan of the new ones, but the old ones, the Mark II Mark ones. This is a real nice looking one. It's had some work done to engine bay, it's had it all brushed.
Yeah, upgraded pipes as well. So we've got braided pipes, silicone piping all throughout. Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, really liking that, guys. West Yorkshire Owners Club, I think it is. West Yorkshire, let's have a look.
Yeah.
Ford Owners Club. A lot of Fiesta here. Got the Deadpool detailing. Quite like that.
Yeah, I do like that. And we've got, what's this, Silver Fox. Customs bespoke artwork, so if you're interested in that, there you are, guys.
Looks good if you're looking at something. So I've got a Blacked Out ST Mark Black, Scooby, Mark Priest, ST, another Focus ST, Irish Wheels.
I don't think I want
RS Wheels because I don't want people to think I'm trying to make mine look like an RS. I think I'm going to go for some Bolt.
I like the
detailing is done on this.
Compliments are good. I like that, it's quite unique.
Yeah, it's also really West Yorkshire's Owners Club. Yeah, I like that.
So is this the Mondale? The 220 estate version, is it?
Short,
could be wrong.
Yeah, it's the ST, it's the diesel one.
Well, I like these, got the twin exhaust. I think Jeremy Clarkson had one of these. He thought this was one of the best cars you can have with the V6, I think they are. Oh no, it's the diesel, I'm not getting myself into it, I'm not sure if the TDI one has the V6 engine. I don't think it does. Could be wrong. So we've got another ST. The bonnet latches. I personally wouldn't do them that way, but I'm going to be fitting these soon to mine. I'll be doing a video on that. So make sure you subscribe to the channel to view that one.
Right. Please, mate.
We've got a CFR. Hydro-dipped engine bay.
Yeah, tuning box on it as well.
I do like the Skulls. I'm a big fan of Skulls.
Different,
yeah. I like it.
Very nice, buddy, very nice.
Thank you.
Yeah, the children are in the car. Yeah. You can tell these are proper car owners because they leave the children in the car whilst they go and explore. Yeah, they've been left there a few years. Bit of Iron Man detailing there. But you missed that one. Of an ECU boxer. Looking out, is that another? Never see that, isn't it? Cooper, I think it is. Could be wrong.
What you got?
Could be wrong.
Very nice.
Yeah. I think they're a fan of the Seats on this one, of the Seats there. Yeah, some work done to this engine bay.
Looking tidy. Looking tidy. Hold on.
Oh, the Torado. I can't pronounce it. Torado. I've got a Ferrari here, but is it a Ferrari? Can anyone tell before we go down with it? Well, that looks like a Ferrari engine bit.
I don't know if that's a Ferrari or not.
Hold on, Italian replica club.
So it's a replica of a 430 Dornacar MR2 turbo. Yeah, could have guessed that. MR2 turbo.
But to be fair, no, I don't think any Ferrari would have £15 bonnet bent on them. Owners Club part here, this is their stand. Got Chevrolet Camaro RS. Is it the Bumblebee car, as everyone calls them?
Anything?
That's what I call it. If I see one of these, I think Bumblebee.
Set four jags.
Is that the R? Do you call them the R?
The F-type
R's,
is it?
F-type R's, yeah. Now these are nice. These sound really nice. We've got a red, a couple of blacks, a silver. I think I'd prefer the four exhaust rather than the twin rear exit. Yeah, I think I prefer the third two.
We've got another Mustang.
Mm-hmm.
GT.
Yeah. Once again, grey, my favourite colour.
Nice white car, Spider.
See, why can't more cars do leather and Alicante suede? Right, if you think back to the Renault Clio 182 that I should be showing over there, they come with leather and Alicante suede Recaro seats, and they are comfy. Really comfy. And next to the beautiful Spider, we have a Volvo. But this isn't just a normal Volvo. Can anyone just tell? It looks normal, but it is the Polestar. Now these are really quick. They're about 300 something horsepower. Not 60, it's about
4.5
seconds. But to look at it, you'd think it's just like a normal V60, but nope. I think these are quite rare as well, aren't they? Yeah. Caught the owner there with a mouthful of burger.
Yeah.
Yeah, these are rare, aren't they?
I've had it for 2 years and I've never seen another one on the road.
I've never seen one ever.
No.
It's the first time. I knew it when I saw it, and anyone watching this now would probably have just thought it was just like a
sleeper.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, it's like a sleeper car, really.
It is, yeah.
I bet you put some people to shame.
Oh yeah, it does, yeah.
They're very quick.
Frightens me to death sometimes.
I bet it does. Are they all-wheel drive these?
All-wheel drive.
All-wheel drive, hence why they're not 60 so quick.
Yeah, it's an 8-speed sequential box on it.
Have they got 8-speed sequential?
Yeah.
Wow. I think this was on Top Gear, wasn't it?
Yeah, that would have been the older one, the 3-litre. This is a 2-litre.
Bad. Yeah, when more economical.
Yeah, but... The 3 litre was turbocharged only. This is supercharged and turbocharged.
Supercharged and turbo. Now that is an almost sleeper car there. Well, thank you very much.
Almost sleeper car.
I don't know. That's out there for anyone to decide. Another. These are the import Vauxhalls from Australia.
Monaro.
Monaro. So these are quite beastly. These sound good, they're V8s. So it's like a V8 Monaro. They only can get in Australia, but you can't get them imported. And a very special car is next to it. Evolution 8, is it? Mm-hmm. Evo 8. Once again, my favourite colour, grey. Which is a bit obvious now.
Really good condition now.
Yeah, I would... I think I'd sell my kids for one of these. No, I'd never do that. Nah, my daughter's with me, she's giving me evils now. But no, yeah, that is really nice, super quick. For me, anyone knows me well, I like quick. I'm not bothered about top.
Go.
Another Mustang, another Porsche GTS. One of my favourite colours in the Porsches. There's always a big debate on these Porsches, that they all look the same. Yes, they do. But when they're throwing them out in this colour, it gives them very more unique. And next to it is a beautiful Ferrari. What Ferrari is this, Snappy? You know more than me.
488 GTB.
488 GTB.
Mm-hmm.
B. GTB.
Mm-hmm. In the on the inside console.
Ah, yes, 480 GTB. And look at the engine bay on that, it's beautiful. Looks like it's got a bit of... looks like it's got gold, it might just be my shades. Once again in grey, huge calipers. They must be 8 pop. Can't go. I don't know for certain, I'm just guessing by looking at them. Beautiful guys, this is a very nice car. Very nice car.
up to 30.
Yeah. Gorgeous. Gorgeous there, guys. That's a rare car that most people never get to see. We've got some more Porsches, but another 911 in red.
Being used as a family car, it's got a child seat in it. Some cars should be driven.
He's not here.
GT3,
is this?
Lovely GT3.
Yeah, they're a lot more aggressive looking than the GT3, which spoilers. Got another F5.
With half roll cage in, by the looks of it. A full roll cage.
Now, this colour scheme here, this is actually the colour scheme that I'm going to change my ST to. I'm going to go for the grey and this sort of like Cadbury's kind of colour.
In great condition.
Couldn't tell you what type of Nova it is, whether or not it is the GSI. Does it Nova?
I don't know.
Don't have a go on me if I get wrong. I'm sure Nova did a GSI. Or could be wrong. Then we've got a line of beautiful Capris.
Look at these. These are clean.
I don't know which one I prefer.
Yeah, but I mean, you got the nice black. We got the V6 model with the red leather, checkered interior on that one, but I think I like the mint green. It looks mint green, I could be wrong. You got a 3.1 gear, 3 litre. There you go, you got the S6 V6 engine block there. Naturally aspirated. Best thing about naturally aspirated, guys, I think it's aspirated, right? I can't see a turbo. Because I'm not well in down with the information on these, but all I can guarantee with that naturally aspirated is there's no turbo lag. And it is amazing not having turbo lag. See this one's clean. Look at them. I love the black of the checkered cloth interior.
They are used
well now, actually. Yeah. Electric fan just kicked in because the engine is registering too hot. Yeah.
It's
happening cold. I'm not sure. Mazda. Oh, he's done some work on engine block.
So if anyone's looking at this, ever wondered what that means, direct overhead cams. So now you know.
There we go there, again.
Direct overhead cams, 16 valve Vauxhall. Dump valve. I bet that sounds quite nice, that, on this.
And we've got another Vauxhall. Nice, classic Mini Air. That seems like some engine upgrades by the looks of it.
Yeah, it's definitely an upgraded engine. I don't know if it's... John Cooper conversion. Got the stamp of authority. So there's a John Cooper conversion done to it. Nice fat wheels. Yeah, that's nice. So that's gonna be quick. Very quick. I love these. This is a car I'll definitely have one day. A nice Volkswagen Beetle. Now that, look at that. That is cool. That is cool. I think it's working as a catch can. Is this yours? Is the Jack Deere catch can? There you are then. So that is a cool, that is for your window washers. That's your top up bottle. Yeah, that's cool. That's cool that. But, nice.
That was. Sierra Cosworth 4x4.
Yeah, so we've got the Sierra RS Cosworth 4x4. These are worth a fortune, guys.
This is an investment. If you buy one of these, you're never going to lose your money. You're going to make money. So we've got a line of boxes for these are becoming a classic, these. You don't see many of these about now. And I think the turbo, this one is cream of the crop.
He's done a lot of work to engine. I'm sure these were a V6 as well.
Could be wrong.
I don't know, to be fair. But that's a nice engine there.
Lovely RS.
Mexico. This gentleman has just told me he's won this Mexico in a raffle 22 years ago. Wow. That's like a bit like a lottery for you now, isn't it?
It's my retirement.
This is your retirement. You're going to show me. Oh, untouched engine bay.
No, I've cleaned it.
Other than clean, but I mean, it's not been. It doesn't look like it's been changed in any shape or form, other than a bit of silicone piping.
Yeah.
Wow.
I
love. That is. Yeah. You do right keeping it original as possible. That's really nice.
It's even to use the exact same heater motor as what Capri's had in it. So you can buy a brand new Mercedes motor, put it straight in. So I did, £35. And it's a tiny motor, you know.
But you might show my age by saying I like brown all the time. I can't pronounce it.
Console.
Console. A Ford console. I have never seen one of these. It's got like a
ups and downs, but
leather. Wow. Leather headtops. Amazing. Classic Vauxhall. Now, this, in my opinion, these Cavalier SRIs. They come in 2 litre with obviously a nice twin exhaust. These from Cavaliers, in my eyes, were the best. These Cavaliers, these Vauxhalls were, in my opinion, when Vauxhalls were nice. I mean, everyone to their own, everyone has their own favourite bands. I'm not a big fan of the new Vauxhalls, but these, any day. There you go, guys, that's the end of the video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, support the channel by hitting the like button and subscribing. And if you want to see more videos from myself in the future, then just turn on the bell notification. And a big thank you to Harrogate Car Enthusiast for putting on the show. It was a real good show. It was a good day. A good variety of cars turned up. There's loads of nice people I spoke to who were happy to talk to me about their cars. And there was a lot to do for the families and the children. There's burgers, ice creams, the full work. So it's definitely worth a visit for next year. So yeah, if you're around that area, you know, definitely go down there, and I'll be heading down there next year as well. Nice GTR going by. But yeah, till next time, guys, thank you very much for watching. Check out the ECP supporter in A&K Motorsport for your Ford Focus ST RS Mustang online parts. I'll leave a link in the description. Oh, and I do apologize if your car is not in the video. Oh, I couldn't put them all in, unfortunately, because of the video would just be far too long. So sorry about that. Alternatively, check out our ECP in-house photographer Snapper on his Instagram page. I'll leave a link in the description where you can go and view that, because there's a good chance he's got photos of your cars and they'll be on his Instagram page in the following days and weeks. So thanks very much, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Laters.